Hello and welcome to Make This. Today we're going to learn how to make the simple circle wipe transition that you see on screen in Alight Motion. Great, let's get started. So making a circle wipe is actually very easy, and if you're a beginner to Alight Motion, this is the perfect video for you. All we need to start is two images and a circle. Believe it or not, that's all we need to get through this. So right now, let me go and add my images. So that's the first image, and of course you can add images by tapping plus media and then going through the images that are on your device. I'm going to choose these two here, the first one because it's circular and I like that, and the second one because it's also another photo of pencils, and I think that'll match nicely. Great. So what I would like to do is I'd like to transition from one of these images to the other. And when I say transition, I mean going from one scene to the next. In the community online, transition can mean many different things, but here when I talk about a light motion, I mean going from one scene to the next. In this case, going from one image to the next. And this is what we're going to do. Great. So now we have our two images, and as I said, I should also add a shape. I'm going to pick a circle, leave it right in the middle. That's perfectly fine. And this is all we need to add to our timeline to make our wipe. Now, how do we actually make a wipe out of this? Well, the first thing we need to do is we need to animate our circle. Our circle should start from a point that's invisible, and then it should spread to fill the whole screen. That's what a wipe does. And that's what we're going to make our circle do. Now, don't worry about how we're actually going to get the wipe out of this yet. Just follow along. Trust me, we'll get there. Now, let's tap on the circle, and then I'm going to tap move and transform. And this is where basically all our movements, all our transforms, scaling, skewing, everything happens in this tool. And I'm going to tap scale down right here on the bottom right. And I'm going to scale this all the way down to zero, or as close as I can get it. Oh, -1, -1, that's fine. You can't really see it on screen. Great. Now what I want to do to animate, okay? So I want to animate from nothing until it fills the whole screen. What I want to do is I want to add a scale keyframe at 0 seconds by tapping the add keyframe button. Now, this keyframe tells Alight Motion that we want that circle to be that scale at that point in time. Okay, now that's important. Now, if we go over to, let's say, 1 second, that's probably enough. We want to add another keyframe. Now that we've already added one keyframe, we can change the value of scale and another keyframe will appear automatically. And so what we're going to do is we're going to just scale this all the way up so that it covers the screen, and we also want to give it just a little bit of extra space just in case. So now we have two keyframes. The keyframe at 0 seconds says make the circle a point. The keyframe at 1 second says make the circle fill the whole screen. And because those two keyframes are of the same type, they're both scale keyframes, okay? And because they have different values, Alight Motion will automatically animate between them. So if I move the timeline down, you can see the circle gets smaller, and again it gets bigger, smaller and bigger, smaller and bigger, smaller and bigger. Great. Now if we just play that through, we can see that we have the circle there. Right. Now that's wonderful. Now, right now, this circle here is moving at a constant speed. Maybe you want that, but in nature, things tend to speed up and slow down as they move. And when, especially when you're starting to move from being still, it takes you a little while to kind of gear up. For example, like a car, a really fast car won't automatically be going 100 kilometers an hour down the road. Oh, sorry, 60 miles down the road. Oh my God, you found out my secrets. What we can do, okay, is we can make it so that this transition will start off slow like a car will, and then it will accelerate until it reaches full speed over time. Now, what we can do to do this is we can put our playhead right here in between two of the keyframes that we want to change, these two active keyframes. And on the bottom left, we can press easing. Now, this curve right here, this graph, shows us how fast the animation is going, how fast the object in the animation is going over time between the two keyframes. If the curve is closer to horizontal, that means it is going slow at that point in time. And if the cursor is going, if the curve right here is closer to vertical, that means it's going faster. So what we just did now is we made the cursor move slowly in the beginning and then quickly speed up at the end. So if you play through it, you can see there's a little bit of woo, starts slow and then speeds up. Wonderful. So that's how things behave in nature, and that's usually a pretty good way to think about how you should curve your animations if you want to. Right, so now we have added two keyframes. We have added an easing curve to define how we want it to move, and we have basic animation, right? So this circle grows, wonderful. Now what we need to do is we need to make it so that we are actually moving from one image to the other with the circle, not just having this big green circle appear out of nowhere for no reason. And what we can do, how we can do that is by using masking groups. Now, masking groups, what they do is they take the content of one layer and then they put that content in the shape of another layer. And this process is called masking. Now, so what you can do to do a masking group is you can tap, long tap here, and highlight the layers that you want to be in the masking group. And then you can go to the top right of the screen to the overflow menu and you can choose create masking group. Oh. Ah, see? And now you have your wipe. So what our masking group did is, if I go back again, what our masking group does is it takes this image here that we've selected, the pencil image at the top, and it masks it to the shape of the circle. And because the circle is already animated, this stays inside of it and we get the effect that we see here. Boom. And now we have a circle wipe between these two images. Again, you can do this with video. You can do this with just about anything, actually anything in the app, with drawings or anything else. You can use this to wipe between them. So I hope this was helpful. If you need to learn more about keyframing or animation in general, please check our Getting Started videos. They go through them in much more detail. If you want to see something a little bit more complicated, or if you want to see something a little bit more easy, please let me know in the comments. And don't forget to enjoy your wipe. Kind of like that. Bye.